Hello, I'm Nigel Poulton, and this is your weekly Kubernetes moment. Okay, so the other day I posted a video on service meshes and why they're super important, right? And on the YouTube chat, I had a question asking, so yeah, you deploy a service mesh, but actually how does the sidecar get in there and how does it all work when you do scaling operations and stuff like that? So I thought I'd do another video this week explaining that. The crack is, right, you develop your application, whatever language you prefer, of course, package it up as a container image, and then you wrap that in a pod spec that defines how you want your application to run on Kubernetes, yeah? Then you probably deploy it with a high-level controller like a deployment or a stateful set or something like that. Anyway, as you come to deploy your YAML manifest file, you post that to the Kube API server. That gets the request gets authenticated, authorized, and once it's been authenticated and authorized, then something called an admission controller kicks in. Now, your service mesh will deploy an admission controller to your Kubernetes cluster. So you've got your YAML file, you post it to the API server. Yes, authorization and, well, authentication. Is this genuinely Nigel who's trying to deploy this? Yes, it is Nigel. Then it becomes authorized. We know it's Nigel. Is Nigel allowed to do this action, deploy this object onto the cluster? Assuming all of that is yes, then admission control kicks in. An admission control from a service mesh perspective can do things like implement policies. So it may look at the manifest that is being deployed and say, okay, this is being deployed, I don't know, right, to the production namespace. And we have a policy that says anything in the production namespace must have a service mesh sidecar proxy injected directly into that pod. So you don't have to care about how the sidecar container gets in there. That's all left up to your service mesh. I don't know if that's simple or confusing, so let me run through just one more time. You develop your application, package it as a container image, wrap it in a pod, deploy it through whatever controller you want. Let's just call it a deployment controller, okay? You have a service mesh running on your Kubernetes cluster, and the service mesh implements an admission control, probably a webhook-based admission controller or something like that, so that when you post your YAML manifest file to your cluster, the admission controller, as part of admitting that object to the cluster, the admission controller looks at it, says, oh yeah, okay, so I've got a policy, and it might be because it's being deployed to a particular namespace, it might be because it's got a particular label against it, but the service mesh's admission controller will say, ah, I've got a policy that says I have to insert a sidecar container into this pod. And that is how a container or a sidecar container gets inserted into your pod spec. Now, of course, this works with when you deploy entirely new objects. It also works as well though for scaling operations and things like that. Boom! I'm Nigel Poulton. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you're going to KubeCon, give me a shout out. We'll talk, we'll connect, we'll catch up. See you there. Now then, I know that this is a bit random that I'm recording it in the car, right? But think about it. I'm recording it in the car because we're talking about sidecars! Woohoo!